Lord. Welcome to Solid Rock International Ministries. My name is Pastor Cynthia. On behalf of our Bishop, Bishop Mickey Okeo, I welcome you to Solid Rock International Ministries and our senior pastor, Pastor Nicholas Ayesa. We are so glad to have you here today, and we hope God has kept you safe ever since we met until now. Indeed, to God be the glory. Today, we are going to talk about anger and letting go of our anger. There is nothing good that has ever come out of anger. Instead, it's negative emotions. It is our human nature, and it is natural always to feel angry. So, never ever feel bad when you feel angry. But the only important thing is always to be aware and to understand on how to control our anger. I'm going to give you a story just to relate on how anger is really affecting us in terms of our daily-to-day living. This is the story. There once lived two couples, a husband and a wife. They had a quarrel and they decided not to talk to one another. By this I mean they used to communicate using notes. And by this time, there is this time when they had their night, they were sleeping. And the wife was attacked. The wife was asthmatic. The wife had an attack and was asking the husband at least to assist. And by this time, she was unable to speak. So the only thing that she was doing was only hitting towards the husband so that the husband could offer help to him. But the husband ignored. Why? Because the husband thought of the quarrel that they had and they decided not to speak to one another. In the morning, the husband woke up and decided to dress and went to work. Never bothered to check unto the wife if the wife was okay, sleeping or slept well or something. So the husband decided to walk away and went to work. In the evening, when the husband came, he found things the way he left. The house was unkept. The house was unkept and the wife was still sleeping. While going towards the wife, he realized that the wife was not responding, even trying to raise up his hand, even breathing. She was not breathing. This is when she realized that the wife was long gone. She was dead. It came to him that the wife was asthmatic, and that night when he was trying to hit him, it was like she was having an attack, and the inhaler that the wife was using was not near her. So this came up like a guilt towards the husband because the wife died because of him. Now, let us relate. If the husband could have laid aside the anger that she was having towards the wife, probably as we speak, the wife would have been alive. Now, we can relate this story with each and everything that we usually do. Like when we are angry, upset, we decide to do things that are not right. Even if when we go through all those things that we are doing, we feel like we are acting towards our negative emotions. And even we tend to see like we are exaggerating. In the Bible, what does the Bible state about anger? In Psalms 37 verse 8, don't give in to worry on anger. It only leads to trouble. That is in Psalms 37 verse 8. When we give ourselves towards anger, it only leads to trouble. This one we can see that there is nothing good that comes out of anger. In Proverbs 29 verse 22, people with quick temper cause a lot of quarreling and troubles. We have noticed on how us we relate outside here and the way we react when we are angry. Only small thing we react unto it and make it explode like a big trouble because of what we have responded quickly towards the anger that we are having. It's always good to cool down, relax, analyze ourselves, see ourselves. Is it good to respond towards whatever that we are getting angry to? In Proverbs 15 verse 1, A soft answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. We have found ourselves in many circumstances. When we are angry, we respond bitterly, majorly using the word why. And in most cases, when you use that word why, we are trying to, like, defend ourselves. And if we are trying to defend ourselves, the person that we are trying to ask the word why also will come defending themselves, and it won't come out to be right. We'll find ourselves arguing, quarreling towards one another, and things are not going to be calm. I believe when something wrong has happened, I know at times we see ourselves that I'm not the one that made that thing happen, or I'm not responsible to that situation, or that thing that made that person angry. But again, does it cost us anything to say the word sorry? Because I believe when we learn to use this term sorry, when we learn to apologize at one time or at each given situation, we always calm down the situation and make the things to become. And at this moment, you can reason, you can speak, you can talk. But how if we raise up our ego, decide not to apologize, decide just to sit there and have that we swallow our pride and think that he or she is the one who is supposed to say sorry, the first person. When you say sorry, I believe you are the winner, not the loser. In Romans 12:21, choose to do good rather than acting on your own negative emotions. Because at any point, when you harbor grudge, when you feel like if somebody has wronged you and you feel like, I'm not going to forgive this person, I'm just only going to revenge towards this person, of what gain are you going to gain? There is nothing. At the end of the day, you'll find yourself carrying burdens that are not going to be easier for you. But the moment you let go and allow this person to be, it's not like you have let go this situation and you have just allowed things to be the way they are. But it is because of your own benefit, your own well-being, your own peace, and also for your own self-being. It's always good, at least, not to harbor grudge upon ourselves. But at the end of it all, when we try to forgive and to let go, we feel lighter rather than when we carry the grudges around us. In Proverbs 29, verse 22, I just mentioned that people that are quick to temper, they cause a lot of quarrel. We have seen that when we act quickly because of our own anger, because of the tempers that we have, we lead to trouble. And when we cause trouble around us, things are not at peace. We should always learn, at least, as I said before, to listen to ourselves, and at least when we feel that we are angry, always listen to ourselves. And if the situation is far much more of above yourself, I believe at times you can let go or decide to keep quiet. At least you allow the situation to calm down, and the end of it, you respond later. It won't cost you anything if you decide to respond later on than to respond at that particular moment. In Psalms 103, verse 8, the Lord is compassionate and merciful, very patient and full of love. At any point you feel that you are angry, at any point, I know that us as Christians, we have found ourselves in this situation that I'm speaking about. You can always go back to God. Ask God for forgiveness. Ask God for guidance. And God, I believe, is going to guide you to the path that is correct. And if we rely upon God and not to rely upon man, because I believe at most cases of our life, we usually rely upon people by which we end up to be disappointed. Because we only trusted those people, and we trusted that these people are the ones that are going to assist us. But the moment this person is unable to assist us, we end up to be disappointed, and we have anger, and we end up having these grudges that won't lead us to anything. But the moment we have this faith upon God and allow God to guide us in this path, and allow God to be the person who is in control in each and every of our situation, I believe we shall be in peace, each one of us. We have seen many of us in these times of this living that we are in. The situation is not good. Things are hard. We are lamenting, each one of us. Each and everything is becoming to be difficult. I believe you have seen people speaking to themselves outside here, like talking and responding to themselves. I believe these are due to the angers that we are having. And this bitterness, they are making us to have these angers that are making us even have the mental illnesses that are triggering the world today. These mental illnesses that are growing rampant towards today, it is because of this bitterness and angers that we are having. Because we don't allow ourselves to speak out. We don't want to allow ourselves at least to state out the problems that we are having. If you have a problem, it's always good at least to speak out. Don't try to look or see, what is this person going to think of me? Am I the only person having this problem? Whatever this person is going to think of you does not matter. The only thing that matters is when you speak out your problem, it's like you are lighting up the burden that you are having. Even if this problem is not going to be solved, but at least you are going to at least understand that you are not the only person going through the problems that you are passing through. And the person who has problem and fears to speak out, don't feel like you are the strongest person, because at the end of the day, you tend to be weak. It will reach a point in your life whereby these problems that you are harboring inside will not be lighter to you, and you are going to explode. And when it explodes, things are not going to be okay with you. I believe, as you have seen and as you have relayed outside here, mental illness is not a good thing. It's a serious thing. And when we speak out our problem, things are going to be okay. I pray that the Lord is going to assist us, so that us all, we are going to understand that each and every troubles that we are going through upon our lives is not only us. And if there is any trouble that we are going through, there is also another person that went through the same trouble and came outside of that trouble, and all shall be well. I pray that the Lord may continue to assist us, and the grace of the Lord is going to dwell and upon our lives. I know there is somebody outside here or somebody watching me today that is going through anger and bitterness upon their lives today. I'm going to stretch out my hands towards you so that we can pray together for the Lord to assist you, for you to let go of that spirit of anger and you to be peace in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, I thank you for this glorious day that you have blessed us with. I pray for my brothers. I pray for my sister who is harboring anger today, who feels like he or she doesn't want to let go. I pray that Jehovah Jireh, that you may touch over them and release that spirit of anger in the name of Jesus Christ, for them to remain at peace and for them to be at peace with themselves and with the people that are around them. I believe that Jehovah Jireh, you are going to do good and your will upon their lives. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, trusting and believing in you. Amen. I know we have prayed together and the Lord has done his will. I'm going to request all of you, kindly, like and share our YouTube channel. Don't be blessed alone. I know this message is going to bless another person. Don't be selfish. Kindly invite other people to like and share our page. Be blessed and the Lord be with you.